hi YouTube. So I haven't really done a video since I got to San Diego because the start of San Diego didn't start off too well. I was booked into an Airbnb, but when I got there it was an absolute dump and there was nowhere I was going to stay there. So once the guy who had greeted me went, I just packed my stuff up, left and went to a hotel that night. So at the moment I'm fighting to try and get my money back on that place. And now I'm back on a campsite. But I have found another good Airbnb which I'll be on in about 4 days time, which means it just makes things easier for me that I can leave my stuff somewhere safe. I haven't got to keep putting it in the bike because I can't leave it in my tent. So it means I can explore a bit more and not worry about leaving the bike parked up. So that's why that. Then I had to get my bag changed on the back of the bike that I got from cyclegear.com because the bag had split. It's like a PVC bag and it split, but they were really good and I've got like a nylon one now. So I had to sort that out. And also then I had to get all the oils changed in the bike. So I've done that now. So this is sort of the first ride I've been able to do since I've got to San Diego. So I'm now heading up Mount Laguna. It's about an hour from where I am at Sweetwater. It's quite a nice ride. I mean, the weather is just amazing here. Sometimes it's a little bit cloudy in the morning, but it soon burns off. I have been down to Mission Beach when I've been waiting for the bike to be sorted and stuff. That's pretty cool. So I've been looking at some rides that I can do, and this was the first one I'm going to be doing. As you can see, it's a cool road to be riding on. So once I get into that Airbnb, I'll be able to, I know I want to go to San Diego Zoo, so I'll be able to do that. So I'll be able to empty everything out of my bike. I don't know how I'm going to get on with trying to get my money back out of them people. We'll see. I've put it in it. I've contacted them, then I've got to wait and then do it through Airbnb, or I'll try and get it back through PayPal, because it was this, I booked it for a month, so it's like £500, so I don't even know how they had the audacity to even put it up for rent. It was so bad. There you go, live and learn. It wasn't like I could check it out, I was too far away. At least I was able to, once I got here, I could check out where I was going to be staying before I booked it. Unfortunately, I was the first person to stay there. It had no reviews. I mean, most of the people that were living there were long-term residents, and they were just like young kids. probably going to have to get a new rear tyre soon as well. I was 10,000 miles and I had all the oil changed. That tyre's obviously done about the same. And it's a lot more expensive over here for things like, well, normally in the UK I would never have somebody else do my oil change for me, but I just haven't got the tools to do it. I'm sure it wouldn't have cost what it cost me to get it done. I've never had it done in the UK because I always do it myself, but like a tyre is more expensive. It's the labour costs are definitely more expensive than the UK, so they must be on a higher wage than we are. And then it's all relative, but over there. I should have stopped. I'll stop on the way back down and get some photos. That would look like some really nice views. So the traffic's pretty chaotic at the obviously normal work rush hour times. It's no worse than being on the M25 and stuff like that. Just have to filter through it, or lane splitting as they like to call it, which is good, so otherwise you'd be stuck in it for ages. It's the busiest place I've been to, for sure, and at some point, I don't know whether I'm going to stay in LA for a bit. I'll have to have a look, because it's bloody expensive to stay in LA. But I've got to go there to sort out about shifting my bike back at some point. So I will just have to ride in there anyway. And I will have to stay there obviously when I drop the bike off, because that's where I'm flying back from. But I may look at staying there for a week maybe before I go back, and I'd love to go to Universal, so we'll see. Mile ago. Oh, we're going back down here. I don't know where this is taking me to. shop or store I think that's up here. It might take me to that. So hitting a 40 zone. So there's gotta be something up here for it to be a 40 zone. That's a campsite. That's a fire department. I've stopped now at a viewpoint down the other side of that Mount Laguna. Pretty awesome views. Check it out. Pretty cool, yeah? I'll go and grab my camera and get some photos. You can hike down as well. But again, I can't. I've got stuff in my bike, like my laptop and stuff, which is when it makes things awkward because I can't lock my bags up, so I just can't take that risk of that stuff going missing. So that's why I really need an Airbnb where I can leave stuff safe. Right, catch you later.